Hey guys, Mr. Pokey here, back with another video, and today, I never thought that I would see this happening, like ever, but it has happened. So, you guys might have noticed, ZMM just posted this video 4 hours ago. I wanted to cover this a little bit earlier, but I was in the middle of doing my Blade rerun review. Check out the video over there, I'm gonna be leaving the link up here. The moment I heard of this is like, this has to be a clickbait. Like, this has to be drama content, like drama baiting content. Because let's be real, drama content in not even just Honkai Star Rail, in any YouTube space, drama is king. Drama is king. All right, so we are going to be taking a look at exactly what the is going on over here, because I did not expect to see this in a million years, right? So without further ado, let's get into today's content. Subscribe! Okay, it already has 16,000 views. I just want to see what can we do before Tekton hops on. I want to do this because I know Tekton is still sleeping. That's the perks of being Asian. We're going to cover this content before Tekton gets here. So I'm gonna cook this right the fuck now, alright? Okay, without further ado, let's see exactly what is going on here.
For Dr. Ratio, because I want to discuss a serious topic today. I want to talk about the worst people I have encountered so far from my experience in Honkai Star Rail that have either stolen my work or have attacked me. So yeah.
Oh, right. Stealing another content creator's work and attacking them. These are really, really bold claims, right? These are not like Guoba versus Gachasmack on HP percentage sphere or versus win percentage sphere or like crit damage sphere versus hit. No, right, this is none of that. This is not like S Go Solo got memed on by half the HSR community for yapping too much. This is none of that. These are serious allegations, and I don't think ZMM is the kind of people to actually make this as a joke or like a banter just for drama. I think there should be some weight before one goes about accusing these two very, very serious allegations, right? So yeah, just want to put it out there.
Attacked me. So yeah, as a relatively new content creator, these experiences have made it hard for me to make content, and I just don't feel safe making content. And I'm even scared of talking about my experience in this video but it's been eating at me for months. So I'll just say my piece and leave it at that.
Let's go.
We got content police on high patrol today. So I woke up to find a nasty comment. However, this is a small fish in a bigger pond.
Okay, I just want to pause it again. You know how we like a single react content? You got to really stretch out the content. This is going to be a 1 hour video, guys. Okay, but anyways, what is it? Dude. YouTube hate comments. I'm gonna keep it 100, right, guys? I'm gonna keep it 100. There's just so many of them to the point where I find it absolutely pointless to even like address hate comments in YouTube. Like I straight up don't even read them anymore. What I do for me, anyways, when I make my content, I would just give every single comment a heart shape within the first 10 to 20 minutes. So if you guys drop a comment on my Blade video right now, I'll probably give you guys a heart shape, right? So after that, I will just like not read the comments whatsoever. And then if I do scroll past some comments, I'll just be like, that's pretty funny. Or like, oh shit, I feel bad. Yeah, but like, I just found it like completely pointless trying to address YouTube comments. So ZAM, you're an absolutely brilliant content creator. There's no point. It's kind of like a dreamy thing, right? Like when Mr. Chokey's, the people who want to compare Dreamy's clear with my clear, it's completely pointless, guys. So let's just continue.
Well, I woke up to find a nasty comment. Yep. However, this is a small fish in a bigger pond, and there are more serious misinformation and accusations that I want to clarify in just a second. Mm-hmm. So if you guys didn't know, I made a video about gold and gears, and that got a lot of attraction. In the video, mm-hmm. I did a condensed showcase of a run using my strategy in combination with a strategy that I referenced from shout out to Nagfrog, who showcased that his strategy is overpowered. I gave Nag all the credit. He commented and applauded my video. And if you don't know who Nagfrog is, he's a very talented guide maker. I saw one of his videos a couple of weeks ago, and to show my support, I said this: clear and concise explanation. You should do character guides. Okay. You would rock. However, we got a few people coming into my comment section saying that this strategy originated from CN because
I'm gonna be completely 100%. CN discovers so many things, and they discover it so fast. It's like, it's kind of impossible to try and reference. Like, I swear to God, if you thought of something that you think you were the first, CN probably made 20 videos before it, right? Like, even for pure fiction, CN players were literally doing zero cycles. I'm not even talking about 8,000, I'm talking about zero cycles in pure fiction, right? So, to be completely fair to ZMM, if he doesn't watch Bilibili, like, actively watch Bilibili, he probably didn't try to plagiarize CN. He probably doesn't even know that it exists from CN. He probably doesn't even know what Bilibili is, right? So, it's just really, really difficult, and I'll just give him the benefit of the doubt that he didn't intentionally try to plagiarize the CN community, unlike Mr. Choki.
Because in the video, I said Knack's strategy is good. Your strategy is kind of insane, dude. The most insane strategy discovered by KnackFrag. He's an awesome guide maker, and I credited the strategy to Knack, which in my opinion is still correct. Knack was the first to pioneer the shop strategy in global, where I saw it first. But I said if someone can link me a CN source, I will credit them as well. So I ignored it until someone provided a actual source, like a CN creator that did the strategy, which I said, okay, I looked at their content, and they did go over buying out the shop strategy, which, massive, fair enough. I was like, okay, that's fine. I updated my sources to include them as well.
That's so stupid though. Okay, wait. It's so stupid because, like, he literally didn't even reference the guy's video. Like, it's not even referenced at all. It's like, y'all both got the same answer to the same mathematical problem. It doesn't mean that the other guy copied your answer. It doesn't make sense to me. It's like, two people arrived at the same conclusion in their own ways, right? So why would he need to reference this guy's strategy if he didn't even, like, watch the bloody video? Like, oh my god, it doesn't make sense to me.
So shout out to Better Than Nothing. The quality of their videos are amazing as well, and they're very much god tier. And so, yeah,
and being the absolute giga chat he is, he still went ahead and created the guy's video. That's based.
Here I credit them as the earliest usage of this strategy, and Next Guide as my reference for my showcase. More importantly, people have the right to provide other sources as well. And I do my best to exercise due diligence and correct my sources. Because I know what it's like to write a guide or pioneer a strategy.
Oh, shit. Yo, this is... Damn. Okay, in complete transparency, I didn't watch any of these three videos because for Mr. Choki, I couldn't give more fucks about like Swarm Disaster or Golden Gears. Like, me personally, I like to play Honkai Star Rail because I like to stream to my community. We do some MOC cycles and we just have fun at it, right? So I didn't really watch it at all. So I don't know whether our Tumble or even like God Doggos like copied ZMM. But let's see what's up, because this looks a little bit suspicious. Okay, let's continue.
And have it remade and not get a single credit for it. Now, this is in your strategy and have it remade and not get a...
Damn. Okay, so have you guys seen my credits? Okay, I know I get a lot of my references from Bilibili, right? Have you guys seen my credits? It's like, oh, this one. Wait, give me a second. Let me pull up my credits so that I wouldn't get cancelled by the entirety of Bilibili. I actively credit people. Actively.
Nippon Paint.
Oh my gosh. Shut the fuck up. Nippon Paint. Oh my god. Okay, found it. Okay. These are my credits. It's like, yo, I'm not sure about you guys, but I yep a lot in my description. I write like a whole ass essay in my description. I literally type every single thing down to the tracks, the title of the tracks, to the link of the song, to the title, to every single potential possible link that I use. As long as I touch like 5 seconds of it, I'll link the goddamn thing. So that's just like Mr. Choki, right? So I do try my very, very best to give credits where credit is due, right? And yeah, I'm just going to keep it here to make sure that I don't get canceled. Okay, anyways. Let's go back to the video. Let's continue.
get a single credit for it. Now, this is where it gets spicy.
Yeah, you guys can't hear the subs because I offed it just for the purpose of YouTube, right? I'll on the YouTube subs back on after YouTube passes.
Cool. As you all know, I am a free-to-play content creator for the most part. I mean, I do have three accounts. Not meta in Singapore right now.
Is it?
And, you know, a whale and two free-to-play, but that's not the point. But if you were here when Swarm Disaster first came out,
$10 on this
you
game,
probably
by the
saw
way.
This thumbnail. This was my Swarm Disaster guide, okay. A very unique strategy using F2P characters and the Path of Remembrance. Okay. At the time, people knew the Path of Remembrance, but not many people played it. So the combination of this F2P team plus the Path of Remembrance was quite unique. Sadly, back then, Herta wasn't the most built character like she is now. Okay. So when I released the strategy, it was the first of its kind and it popped off. Until, of course, a fewer bigger creators started to write very similar guides, claiming it was the best F2P strategy, using fairly similar teams and explanations 1 to 3 days after mine.
Damn. Okay.
This is what most people would consider a proper way of yoinking and twisting.
YouTube is a beautiful cesspool of inspiration, remixing, riffing, parody. Drawing on existing ideas is a great way of making something new and unique. It's only wrong when you add nothing and try to pretend it was yours in the first place.
And you don't have to cite your sources like a rocket scientist either.
However, this bigger creator, Artumbo, did not yoink and twist. But instead, he just yoinked. He just straight up stole my guide without an ounce of credit, gaining as many views as the original guide, while my video has to essentially compete with my video. How did I know that he stole my guide, though? Oh boy, let me tell you, this guy...
At this point of the video, I am 100% convinced ZMM is not playing around, guys. He's not playing around. He's for real. He's for real, for real. Right, he's for real, for real. So... We're past that now. Yep.
Guy would make the absolute worst criminal. Like, I'm talking about, like, the type to rob a convenience store while asking if they sell ski masks.
He genuinely means this,
guys. So 2 to 3 days after my guide was published, Artumbo releases his Swarm Disaster guide, where he went ahead and used the exact characters and the exact path that I did, the Path of Remembrance. So obviously, that's already a red flag. However, a bigger piece of evidence is that in his guide, he brags about how he's able to clear content while his Herta has level 1 traces.
Unless you have a cracked Herta. I didn't level any of her traces up pretty much, and you'll see that in the build section later.
So he decided that his unbuilt Herta is good enough to beat Swarm 5. Like, you just don't go, oh, let's just use my unbuilt Herta, who I never played in my life before, to beat Swarm 5 unless you've seen the strategy before and you saw the limits of how the strategy works from someone else. Well, you're...
I mean, at this point... Damn. I don't really know what to say because those are some very, very strong evidence against Artumbo here. Very, very strong. Like, it makes sense, right? Like, who in the fucking right mind would go ahead and use, like, a untrained, unleveled Herta with, like, level 1 traces, like, out of nowhere, unless they have gotten some kind of inspiration that, hey, maybe this strategy works. Very, very strong evidence against him here. Not guilty yet, though. Innocent until proven guilty, right? All right, let's go.
You're probably like, okay, well, Zeto, maybe he had some spidey senses about Herta, and maybe he tried the strategy all day to understand the ins, outs, and limits of it in order to make a guide in one day.
Okay.
No. Like I said, this idiot would make the worst damn criminal in the world. He had to go and brag that this is his first attempt.
I think it was my first attempt. And if you do have them built for damage, like a Herta, I will be building Herta for damage, but right now she's not.
You can't make this up. First time Herta, first attempt, exact same team as mine, same relic strategies to run characters typically with their most tanky stats. So defense body, defense orbs, HP orbs.
You do want to be building all your characters with an HP or defense body and orb.
You're not trying to deal damage, you're trying to survive. God.
You do not need any damage percent. You are trying to survive.
Oh, same blessing priorities, and he's not crediting a soul? Lord, he's either a liar or he is the second coming of Jesus. No. actually, you guys are right. Let's give him the benefit of the doubt. So let's say he got all of that first try and God told him everything he needed to know about the strategy beforehand, and that it was just a pure coincidence he used the exact same F2P team as me.
Nah. Okay, at this point, like, the moment he exposed that it was his literal first time being the game. Where is this? Yeah, like, the moment he said it was, like, literally his first time ever using this strategy and it worked, that's, like, I mean, like, you show your cards, man. You've already folded your cards at that point, right? I don't think, what else could... Let's just continue watching.
You know, I just like, hey, you know, hey, it's about 100%, you know? But
like, I would never in my right mind just randomly like, oh shit, Eureka! The unleveled, unbuilt Herta is the best goddamn character in Swarm Disaster 5 because Jesus came to me in my dreams and told me she was absolutely busted, right? Jesus came and told me she's gonna be absolutely busted in Pure Fiction, and therefore 2 months before Pure Fiction, she's gonna come into Swarm Disaster 5 and absolutely beat the fuck out of everybody using the Remembrance Stress. So unless that literally happened, something sussy is going on here. Cool.
The boss wasn't out yet at the time. If it was, what I said still...
You want a bit more?
Ridiculous, right? Don't worry. This will either blow your mind or get you laughing like crazy because of how stupid I am. So in my guide, I said this about the final enemy. Frusting has almost 100% resistance to...
Okay.
To crowd control. So when I said the enemies have almost 100% resist to crowd control, I was actually talking out of my ass. I did not know what I was talking about. I just pulled out random numbers and words because while testing, the boss resisted quite a few of my freezes. And so I felt like it's about 100%, you know? But data on the boss wasn't out yet at the time. If it was, what I said still wouldn't make an ounce of sense because the boss has two separate resistance multipliers. Yep. One, that is the effect res, which it has 50%, and the other debuff res, which it has 75%. And we can't just add these two together because they're multipliers. They're multiplicative values.
Correct. Yep, absolutely.
Used in the formula to calculate the real chance of freezing your enemy.
As a theory crafter, I'm not a theory crafter. I approve of this message. Yeah. It's not 50% plus 75%, you need to get 125%. It's like different multipliers. Yeah, absolutely correct.
So neither are almost 100% by themselves.
It's and a really,
even
really
if
small.
We calculated the effect hit rate of our main freezes, either with March or with the path ability, I'll pick March in this case since she has a lower base chance of 65%. And with these very generous assumptions, we would get a 29% chance to freeze. And if we take the inverse, it would mean the boss has a 71% chance to resist freezes. Which isn't close to or almost 100%.
It's not
so
even close.
I just proved to you guys what I said was, made up. And I was stupid for saying something like that without understanding the intricacy of the formula or seeing the actual data. But you know what's more stupid?
You know, it's funny because like, nobody would even know because the vast majority of Honkai Saru players, they wouldn't even do the math. So it's actually fine. You're good. I'm just saying, you're good. But
stupid. The guy who regurgitated my bullshit.
Because it pretty much has 100% resist against crowd control.
Has almost 100% resistance to crowd control.
It's only wrong when you add nothing and try to pretend it was yours in the first place.
Excuse the ads, guys. I didn't log into my YouTube for this. Okay, you know what? Fuck it. I'll log into my YouTube for this. Let's run it back.
So I just proved to you guys what I said was, made up. And I was stupid for saying something like that without understanding the intricacy of the formula or seeing the actual data. But you know what's more stupid? The guy who regurgitated my bullshit!
Because it pretty much has 100% resist against crowd control.
Has almost 100% resistance to crowd control.
It's only wrong when you add nothing and try to pretend it was yours in the first place.
You can't make this up.
You can't.
The crazy part is,
that is crazy.
I said the right thing, or if I said something vague, like the enemies have a high chance of resisting freezes, and he copied me, then I wouldn't have caught him. Because it would be too vague, or he would reference real data. However, because I said some bullshit and he thought I actually knew what I was talking about. He copied my bullshit and snitched on himself.
He always like that. You know, like, you know what this reminds me exactly of? It's like when you try to copy your friend's answer in an exam, but your friend, like for example, if it was like open-ended essay, and then like the question was like, please describe what happened in the Soviet war and describe what happened in World War II, right? And then your friend wrote, Hitler won or something like this. And then you went ahead and wrote that Hitler won. Oh my god, this is like the exact same scenario, like exactly the same. And like at this point, it's like I feel that at this point, with beyond a shadow of a doubt, I think it's not looking too good.
You can't make this shit up. I don't remember who said this, but one point on the graph doesn't mean much. But when you get multiple points and it starts to draw a line, well, I'd say if you ain't bald yet, you're starting to bald. This is what happens when you literally copy almost everything from someone else's guide. So if his channel, what happens when you literally copy, I'd say if you ain't bald yet. You're starting to bald. This is what happens when you literally copy almost everything from someone else's guide. So if his channel was already way more successful than mine, why do it? Why not give credit, but instead go as far as to steal someone else's guide? Right. The answer is this. Artumbo
copied these people because he thought what they were doing was beneath respect. Plagiarists seem to have this belief they are better than their targets, more important, more deserving of credit, better politics, a better class of person. Your ideas are wasted on you. They'd be much better served in my videos.
And that's the answer. Thanks, H-Bomber guy. He sees other creators especially.
Damn, that is... Okay, like, chat. Initially, I really thought that this was going to be, like, a pretty fun drama video, you know? We get a couple of good reactions in, but, like... It's kind of sad. Like, because Artumbo... Okay, I mean, I have had a few interactions with Artumbo. He really came across like this really, really cool dude. He even showed us pictures of his like Halloween cosplay. Man's like absolutely cracked biceps. To know that this is like happening, it's like, I wouldn't go as far as to say that he was my friend, but like a colleague at work whom you have like maybe like shared meals with, right? Maybe grab a coffee together. And then suddenly you found out that he's like guilty of all these things. It's damn. I mean, I guess it just feels bad, you know? It just feels bad.
The smaller ones as beneath him, undeserving of their own work or respect. He's afraid that his viewers will see his low-quality content mill, compare it to other creators, and decide, hey, I want to watch them instead. Stealing ideas from others and not crediting them. It's a great strategy to double-fuck your smaller competition, really. Not only do you get their ideas, but now they have to compete with themselves. Zeno, you research for days to find out the unique strategy, but I deserve it. Not you. You're beneath me. So your work is my content now. And the ironic part is, I used to watch Artumbo's videos. As seen here, I commented on his Asta video. He even responded, so I know he definitely knew about my channel. But yet he still stole even from his viewer.
This is so sad. Like, it's like watching your friends, like, not even like falling apart. It's like, it's like even worse than falling. It's not even becoming enemies. It's like, they're like suing each other. Because this is basically YouTube court. Whatever you say here, your potential career as a creator on YouTube in Honkai Star Rail is literally at stake here. Because like, if Artumbo, if this drama gets verified and he in fact does this, and like everyone on YouTube exposes him as the way he is, let's be 100% real, guys. His career on YouTube is over. Like, I don't even think miHoYo will be able to continue like their program with. So we're kind of like witnessing a man's career, a man whom I'm not sure if you guys watch him, but I've liked a few of his videos. I really, really liked his QQ video, and potentially this might be the end of his time in Honkai Star Rail. And it's really, really sad that it has to come down to this way. It's really, really sad because like all this could have been avoided with a simple act of including a goddamn reference or citation or whatever you call it in the description. That's why Mr. Pokey always puts a 20 billion essay in his description, right? It means it takes so little of your effort to credit someone else, but it means the world to the other content creators because let's be real, they have indeed taken the time, effort, and research to actually create these kind of content. And all you need to do is to just like, hey, check out this video. Boom, link over here, right? It's really just that simple. And it's sad, man. Yeah, it shows respect, absolutely. Yeah, it shows respect to the other content creators. It really does.
Taking on the hope that I remain silent. And yeah, he was right. I was a coward and I remained silent for 4 months. Yeah, I remained silent. And yeah, he was right. I was a coward. And I remained silent for 4 months. Getting doubly screwed over like what our Tumble did to me really makes a creator not want to create any content. Because if you put out something and he copies it, now you're competing with yourself. And it ate me up for months. After that incident, I really wasn't motivated to make content. And so there was a big 20-day content gap between this video and the next one, right? And that feeling sucks, and I don't wish that on anybody. And so I try to do my due diligence, crediting Knack and Better Than Nothing when I did my showcase. Because it's important to respect others instead of seeing them as beneath you, instead of stealing their flowers. And the grim reality is this, the only way to combat someone taking our work is to talk about it and yep. Let the public, let you guys, the viewers, decide absolutely. For yourself if absolutely. It's wrong or not.
Yeah, oh wait. Okay, actually interesting. Okay, wait, yeah. If this was in Swarm Disaster, why didn't he bring it up like 3 months ago? Yo, like if I was in this position, I would have 100% made a video about it. Like it like that. Like gacha smack. Like I would have boom. If there's this, I'm on it. I am on it. So why did my man wait like 3 months?
Or not? So that's what I'm doing. All I can do is to share my experience. And yeah. But why now, Zeto? Also, you're making it sound like he's
Wow, he read my mind. Yeah, why now? Why now?
Doing this to other creators too. Or you have at least another example, right? That's yep. where the climax comes in. But okay. To truly experience the climax, we must first understand how I got attacked by a bear behind my back. So as you guys probably saw in the thumbnail, little bear, drama certified, he...
Okay, this is supposed to be a serious moment, because we are literally talking about a guy potentially losing his career on YouTube over here. But little bear. Shit. All right, see.
He's back again. You thought he would learn from inciting drama in the public space with Mr. Smack. Oh no, oh no. He's back on form, ladies and gentlemen. He's back. He went from policing misinformation to policing content between two creators who did not have any content issues. Even after Knack commented, applauded my take on the strategy, and gave me his seal of approval, Content Police Certified still had to accuse me of stealing Knack's video. That I remade Knack's video. Look at the tone that he says this. Knack Frog, did ZMM just remake your vid? Frog emoji. What do the pains mean? Knack himself did not fall for the drama bait. He said, yeah, I got credit, all good. And then he says, I'm sure there were plenty of people who figured it out anyway. I was just the first to share it. So the GigaChat himself doesn't take the bait. Oh, but...
Yo, the Knack Frog. Yo, that's Matt based. That's pretty based. That's pretty based.
By the way, instead of doing this privately, forgot this was public certified, said all of this in a public Discord chat, the StarDB general chat.
Wait, what Discord is this, chat? What Discord is this? Yo, someone link me up on my Discord. Yo, what link? Yo, how many members does this place have? StarDB? How many members does this have? Yo, I gotta join this, man. I gotta join. I didn't even know. More than Pokey's Village ain't no fucking way. Okay, but anyways. Okay, we'll hop on. Can someone send me the link? Just DM me the link. Just DM me the link. Thanks.
You can't make this shit up. Like, you can go look at it right now, and it's there. And when I called out the backstabber for it, he just said, oh, back reading, nervous Pepe emoji. So he thought I wouldn't catch his ass in 4K. Unlike you, I personally reached out to Knack in private, even though he said he was all right with it. Even though he said he
Pause. Yo, we have... Yo, wait, chat. Yo. Can I just say, at this moment, Pokey's Village has more members than this Discord, right? So if you guys want a very active community filled with friendly villagers, then hop on over to Poki's Village, right? Where we have a very active community talking about Hong Kong story on a daily basis, right? See you guys at discord.gg/Poki's Village, right? Anyways, I'm hopping right the fuck now. Oh my god, it's still there! It's still there, Guoba! Why would you not delete this? Oh my god.
Told you it was okay. I made sure again because that's the right way to do it. And he said this. No, that's all good. There's no way I can lay claim to a way to play the game. I enjoyed watching your take on it. Quite entertaining. Appreciate the shout out. Man, I've never seen so much GigaChat energy in my life.
He's Thorfinn, guys. He has no enemies. Like, he actually has no enemies. He has achieved what he wants to achieve. He makes a guide. It's a good-ass guide. No drama, no nothing. He just leaves. He has no enemies, guys.
Life. Also, Guoba claimed that I remade the video. I just referenced the dice strategy and mixed it with my own teams using the preservation team to do the showcase with my own take on it. Like Nak said, I enjoyed your take on it. If you just watched the first 35 seconds of the video or saw the credits or looked at the comment section where Nak approved of it, you would have realized there's nothing to police here. And even if you didn't see the video, why are you putting my name in your mouth? Where is Mind Your Own Business certified when you need him? But instead, we get Attack in Public certified. It's ridiculous. What is wrong with you?
Okay, he sounds really... Okay, I can tell, like, from this video, he's, like, holding it in. He's, like, absolutely holding it in. Because if this was real life, it would be, like, fuck, fuckity, fuck, 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 fuckity, fuck, like, all over the place. But he's really, really holding it in. And, yeah, I can tell from the tone. It's like, what is wrong with you, you... Yeah. But yeah.
Imagine if Guoba said this shit in public space behind someone's back like Tectone, Mtash, Brax. He knows it would be game over for him. So he gotta do it to a smaller creator like me. But hey.
Okay, wait. Okay. First of all, let's set the two topics of drama for today, right? We have Artumbo stealing content and Guoba instigating drama. So between these two, Artumbo's one is really like the deal breaker here, because this is like a serious, serious offense. Like, this is like no joke, right? But Guoba, you know, he's just, okay, let's be real. He's just being a dumb, right? He's being a dumb. And I think comparatively speaking, this is definitely the lesser of the two evils. And I mean, it's not nice. It's not a nice thing to do. I mean, why would you do this? Like, why would you do this? But it's not that bad compared to outright stealing what he has made.
Picked the wrong dog to ruffle the fence with today.
It's still stupid.
I remember
stupid.
How he told Gotcha Smack and his Discord that he didn't.
Oh my god. Okay, this is pretty funny. Now you can't just showing a face of Gotcha Smack's. You can't just showing Gotcha Smack's face out of nowhere. Like, look at this.
Like replying or being part of drama that they can get their views, I'll do my content. Yet he goes and falsely attacks another creator's content just to get what? 8 ayaya emotes?
What the fuck? 8 ayaya emotes? What? No, that's just...
That's more pathetic than getting views. The hypocrisy and ego of this guy is bigger than No Man's Sky. It's like I'm endorsing a smaller creator and Content Police Certified drives by and says, sorry, I don't like this. You gotta go to content jail now. Gotcha Smack said it best.
You expect it from the randoms, but you don't expect it from another content creator.
The ironic part is no one is saying this. Like, none of you guys who watch my videos are saying this. And not even randoms did this. Except Guoba, who is arguably the top 3 biggest Star Rail creators. That's the mind-blowing part to me. Like, a creator would risk their whole entire reputation to stroke their ego over others. This is...
Okay, I feel... Okay, I'm being like super, super objective, right? Because this is like my first time hearing about this. I feel at this point, ZMM might be stretching it a little bit, because it's not like Guava Certified made like a whole ass video condemning ZMM, right? This is like a, okay, let's be real, StarioDB is not like a super big Discord. It's like a 7,000 members, right? So what it said, it probably got attention to like maybe like what, 20, 30 people in the Discord, maybe at best, right? Okay, let's just give it 100, right? So I would say it's kind of like a distasteful joke that you just said it too loud. It's distasteful. It's not a great joke. But I don't think Goba here is like outright trying to like destroy like ZMM or like condemning him, like telling everyone like stop watching ZMM or like this kind of stuff. So, oh, that's just, this is my opinion, right? I think it's not that bad. I feel just it's the distasteful joke that was like spoken in it's a public Discord, but it's not a very, very big Discord. Yeah.
Poor form, little bear. If it's two things I hate the most, it's people that put others down to make themselves feel better and people telling me what to do when they don't have the right to. All right. So my friend was right. It doesn't matter what Guoba's opinion is, as long as Knack and I have no issues with it.
Yep.
This reminds me of that, like that one soul dude who literally self-inserted himself into Tekton's business to incite drama when Tekton and the other creator already hashed it out.
It's called Steak and Eggs.
You like that?
And my opinion of you changed, because I was like, okay, well, when he's not talking about Genshin, he's not making a fucking clown of himself. So
you're probably wondering, Zeto, why did you put Artumbo and Guobo in the same video?
Former minor, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, you guessed it. They are creators that have supported each other on multiple collabs, and they have commented on each other's videos constantly. So we know that they are friends, at least on the creator level. And in that case, one, Guoba Certified got a friend who steals, remakes videos, and does not credit. And two, we all know that Content Police Certified loves to call out people in public for remaking videos. Well. Send me to Facebook Live and...
Well. Hot diggity damn.
Call me a conspiracy theorist, but there might be a correlation here. If you ask me what 1 plus 2 is, I'd say 5. And that brings us to the climax. Artumbo is doing it again? The Yoink and Artumbo? Say it ain't so. Okay, so someone tipped me off and says that Artumbo posted a video of the same exact strategy that I referenced that Knack made and stuff like that. And it's the same strategy that you saw Guoba saying I stole. He's doing that right now. What a surprise. It's the capitalism strategy that Knack wrote and that I credit Knack.
At this point, I just want to say, CN has made this video like way before any of these. So I'm just going to put it out there. Not to say that they are like, we're stealing from the CN, but like, I'm just saying from Bilibili, if you guys watch Bilibili, like within the day itself, people have really discovered this capitalism strategy. It's like 无限碎片 strategy or something like that. It's like infinite cosmic fragments and you just buy out the entire shop. And like, I'm just putting it out there. So either Artumbo watches Knack, ZMM, or Artumbo just watches Bilibili, right? One of these above. So maybe Artumbo might have got the idea from from Bilibili, right? Maybe they've gotten it from Bilibili. Because you know, Bilibili is the opposite. Anybody can watch Bilibili. So yeah, I'm just saying.
But the funny part is, he didn't credit anybody on this. He didn't say, hey, I saw it from here.
What am I looking at?
The thief!
I'm pretty sure he's not referencing anything because he thinks we're all beneath him, right? You know what? Let's go ask Guoba. Ask Guoba about it. So yeah, I painfully watched the full video and he used the exact strategy that Knack provided and even labels one of the chapters capitalism. But doesn't mention Knack at all. Doesn't link his YouTube or say it anywhere. So the very same strategy that Guoba accused me of stealing and remaking from Knack, even though I gave everyone credit and Knack approved, is now being taken by Artumbo, who didn't reference anyone. Not even CN players. This is your guy, Guoba. Wait, I know. Let's check Discord. Maybe Content Police Certified condemned Artumbo like he did me in a public Discord chat, right? Not this one. Nope, not this one either. Actually, here's a good idea. Hey, Guoba, at Guoba.
He actually said this. There's no way he said this, right? There's no way he said this.
But did Artumbo just remake Knack's video without an ounce of credit? No, I'm not that petty. I'm not that. When I
Yeah, he didn't, guys. He didn't. Yes. It's fine. It's fine. First of good. First
of good. Asked Knack about our tumble taking the strategy he pioneered without crediting anyone, he said this. Sadly, I figured that kind of behavior would be more common than not. So I was actually surprised to get mentioned at all in your video. So yeah, our tumble would rather step on them, take their belongings, and claim it.
Ew. Whoever Neck Frog is, okay, I'm sorry I've never watched like Neck Frog's content, but goddamn. This guy is such a giga chat, like holy shit. Where the fuck is Neck Frog? Is this even my account? This is, right?
Yeah. Okay. So if you're Honkai Star Rail achievement, absolutely. He's trying to chase the Glib Witchy.
Oh, but at Guoba, did Artumbo just remake Neck's video without an ounce of credit? No, no, I'm not that petty. I'm not that. When I asked Knack about Artumbo taking the strategy he pioneered without crediting anyone, he said this. Sadly, I figured that kind of behavior would be more common than not. So I was actually surprised to get mentioned at all in your video. So yeah, Artumbo would rather step on them, take their belongings, and claim it as his own since we are basically beneath him. Double standard certified. You held me a higher standard than Artefbo? Calling me out for endorsing and crediting other creators, but not a peep at your friend who steals from the smaller creators you champion to help? And back to the climax. Well, Guoba, since you're such a champion of the smaller creators, you also know our story, and you love calling people out in public for remaking videos, I would be so happy if you can call out your friend Artumbo. And maybe in one of your guys' MemeCraft collab, you can ask him, hey Artumbo, did you steal ZMM, Knack, and other creators' videos? And
please- Okay, at this point, I think he's... I feel like at this point, he's kind of blowing things up a little bit. I think he's kind of blowing things up a little bit. I mean, rightfully so, though, because like, it was a bomb ass video, right? It was like 200,000 overviews. And imagine if someone else just posted the exact same strat and got like literally the same views as your video. So that could have been at least like maybe 200,000 views again. So rightfully so, he's angry. But at this point, I think he's getting a little bit emotional here. Yeah.
Please do this publicly because you seem to love the clout.
Yeah, he's mad.
That's what pain really means. Not being credited at all for your work and having it stolen.
He's definitely mad.
When you climb that ladder, don't pull it up. Ooh. Hold it down like how others have held it down for you. And I've learned to cherish those words, passing down the torch and helping others like how others have helped me. So for Guoba, I hope he learns to be more self-aware. He's a very talented and hardworking guide maker. I hope he can grow his ego into an ego that has self-respect as well as respect for others and avoid going down the wrong path. So yeah, that's my story. I don't know. I guess I just felt like I was falsely attacked by a bigger creator for doing the right thing while the real criminal got away. I highly recommend checking out HBomberGuy's video on plagiarism. It's probably the best video essay I've seen. And since I joined quite a bit of HBomber's clip,
4 hours long. Now we ain't gonna read all it.
It's probably not gonna be much, but I will be doing what he did and splitting the revenue of this video to the victims that Artumbo has stolen from. If you feel like he has stolen from you and you have evidence, feel free to message me on Discord or send a comment. Overall, I was really stressed when making this video. 50% of me just wanted to let it go. The other 50% was like, are you really going to be a coward again and let these guys keep on doing this and potentially have to deal with it again in the future? Then I realized if I don't try to stop these guys now and share my story, they're going to repeat this again to others. And like HBomberGuy said, we can only talk about our experiences. It's kind of lawless out here on YouTube. So the only judges are you guys, the viewers. Facts, and the only thing I can do is just to share my experience and let the judges decide. Thank you guys. I appreciate all the support that you guys have given me. The community has been great. I just can't thank you.
Oh boy. Yeah. See you guys. I wasn't trolling. I think this is probably the biggest drama in Honkai Star Rail. Like ever since Honkai Star Rail launched, this is probably like the biggest guy. Oh shit. Artumbo's community post. Yo, is there a link? Can we get a link to that? Yo, Guoba certified, the man of the hour himself. Yo, hold up, wait. Can you send me the community post? Guoba also made a okay. You know what? I'll just watch it myself. Give me a second. Yo, bad. Yeah. Yo, Guoba. Yo, bad. Give me like 1 second. This is a very, very short essay, but okay. The goal of this post is to address the ZMM in his latest video. The first part is directed to ZMM. Sorry, the swamp guy completely yours and uncredited. Plagiarism is extremely severe and unacceptable. There's nothing for me to say beyond. I will be crediting the proper sources and working to rectify any issues that remain. This also applies to any other blah blah blah. For those of you who are fans of my content, I'm sorry. I know it's pretty disappointing news. I have not only stolen and used another creator's work to my benefit, but I have also caused them harm for the past 4 months. My actions have been inexcusable, and the only thing for me to say is that I will do my best to become better. Damn. I mean, at this point, it's just like my man is. Yeah, got me, right? You got me. I think this is the best he could do right now. But right? This is really the best he can do, because he's completely caught, right? He's absolutely, without a shadow of a doubt, completely caught. So this is probably the best part he can do. Didn't even delete the video he plagiarized. Would you delete a video with... How many views does the video have? Hold up. It's seriously like third most popular video of all time. I think my man probably won't delete this, let's be real. I don't think he'll ever delete this. Or not even like demonetized. I don't think he'll delete this. But anyways, yo, Guoba. Let's get into a call. But before we get into a call, let me just check out your community post real quick. What's up? God damn! Yo, that's a fucking essay and a half, bitch. All right, I guess we're gonna read all that. You made me read all that, right? We're gonna read all that. Hey guys, I messed up. I just wanted to explain the situation. Sorry to ZMM. I'm sorry to you guys. I just want to put this here as a place for everyone wondering the latest ZMM video about. Before we start again, sorry for publicly denouncing you in the Discord server for bringing you hate and discrediting your hard work, and then for not supporting you when you opened up to me about the problems you had. Sorry for not holding accountable to the same standards. I was not a good friend. Finally, I'm sorry for not apologizing sooner. And yes, I'm sorry for being caught. I didn't realize my actions were this severe, and the call message from your side and respect to that made me think that everything was okay. But mistake is a mistake, and apologizing instantly should have been that way. TLDR, I called ZMM in the Discord about remaking a smaller content creator's video whilst failing to see another friend of mine, Artumbo, was doing the same and therefore being a hypocrite. Instead of apologizing like I should have, I brushed it aside. ZMM was holding on to the pain for months and about the thing that I accused him for, which must have been horrible. For a full rundown. In a moment of foolishness, I asked Nicker for a question about blah 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 blah. Okay, we've three seen it, right? Mistake one asking. Well, this feels like your parents caught you wrong, and then your mom is like, okay, you gotta give me like 1,000 words to say about why you should never do this ever again. If not, you're not gonna get pocket money for the next 2 weeks. Something like this, right? So mistake one is asking in public when you can DM a guy, Guoba, come on. Yo, come on, Guoba. That's kind of cringe. Let's be real. All right. The wording, he didn't remake it. He spent time and effort using the info he required, and he even credited the original video. Naked Frog even enjoyed the video in the comments. I know ZNM takes a ton of time for the videos, support him, blah, blah. This is not my business. Neither channel is contributed to me, neither have collabed with me. Naked isn't a friend, but I enjoy his videos when they're recommended. ZNM is past friend, and I enjoy his past. Never let you go, this one's day. Nika 4 replies to me saying it's okay and got credited, it's all good 2 minutes after. Mistake 4, I don't delete the message even though Nika says it's okay, especially since it's a public place. I definitely should have assumed others received the message, and I assume this wasn't that big of a deal. Zero replies to me, first mentioned in the server about how he links his sources and got then corresponded by someone. Replied with holy back reading as a joke, as a first joke. Okay, let's be real, guys. That was a joke. That was a joke, guys. Like, come on. That was okay. I know it might have been distasteful, like from the, if you just like completely didn't know anybody and just like look at it from like a surface value. I think it you might have gone on the wrong, but it's definitely a joke. So yeah. Holy back reading, guys. We need a new emote, by the way. Know that this is the only joke I made, and I will not excuse other actions as a joke. This was obviously one, but it wasn't time and the place to do so. Absolutely. Mistake 5, not supporting my friend or ex-friend. That just defended himself when he didn't have to. Not emphasizing I was okay with it, small, alright, instead of a problem message he deserved, and fixing my error by DMing Nick about it. Not maybe helping him out about this creator he referenced, he was my friend after all, making a joke about it. Okay, calm down with the mistakes, man. He then sees my lack of support, which makes a very serious video on the topic addressing my comment. I understand he stuff from my actions. I can't fault him for going public since I went public. He calls me out for not policing Artumbo despite loving to content police. Artumbo has claimed to copy content. You can see from the video. I wasn't made aware of this remaking until now. The only way I even linked Naked Frog and ZM was because I watched both YouTubers back to back during the Golden Gears era. Sorry for not seeing it earlier and sorry for being a hypocrite. In any case, if this does blow up and ZM does get growth and Naked Frog gets growth, and that's at least a nice twist to this. Oh, he's definitely getting growth. He is 1000% getting growth. You know why? Not because ZMM made this video public. Not because Artumbo is getting exposed. Not because Mr. Choki is streaming this to almost 1,000 viewers. But because Hector is going to make a video about it. 1000%, 1001%, Tecton is going to make a video about it. And the moment Tecton makes a video about it, ZMM is going to take off, guys. He's absolutely 100% going to pop off. So we're looking forward to that. We're looking forward to that, right? There's another lesson for me to learn to shut my mouth. Wait. Night of the Shimbaba. Make guides for people. And while some people may enjoy my personality, I know that most people are here for the info, not for me. I do want to be more for that and develop my personality. But doing with the hate, calling out people is wrong. And I'm sorry for that. I still enjoy training people in the mirror servers, but I will once again invite myself to stay away from those when it gets too far. 100% understand that if it was the same message, I will be upset too. I won't be hiding my comments. Here are the three snippets, snip back and forth. I will post my apology on his YouTube video that was deleted by him in the comments below. Sorry once again. God damn. Right, let me just see what's up. Oh, wait, I forgot to see Artumbo's comments. I'll see what's up later. Let's see what's up. Apology was made, that's what matters. This is a... Okay, yep. Do you think I'll get cancelled by his community by saying this? Take it easy, bruv. Okay, but anyways, yo, wait, let me see Artumbo's comment, and then we'll get into a call, Yo, I'm sorry for, like, stalling a little bit, but, wait, let me see the comments from his community post a little bit. Let's see. Oh, is this an essay? I feel like this sentence has been said like more than anything in like the history of like human civilization. Like not just in YouTube, but like if you got caught cheating like in an exam, right, some crimes, you're cheating on your girlfriend, all this kind of stuff. 99% of the time, you're probably not sorry that you did it. But you're sorry that you got caught, because if you did it, you probably did it with the intention of thinking, I'm not going to get caught. No one does a crime intentionally, and then the next day, like, guys, I did this crime, right? You got me, right? Nobody does that, right? They will only ever say they're sorry once they get caught. So this sentence hits hard. Absolutely. Yeah, but okay. I think we're good with this. Yo, without further ado, part two of the drama, yo. Let me pull up my Discord real quick. Yo, Guoba! Ladies and gentlemen!
That's not my name anymore. I've seen the chat. It's content police certified or court certified now. Drama certified.
Man.
Yeah,
go for it.
Man, I just wish I could talk to ZMM. Not because, like, to get him to delete the video or, like, anything, but I just... Poor guy, I didn't realize 4 months. How was it 4 months that he's been holding on to that?
Right.
And I completely missed it. And like, I should have seen it. But the thing is, I mean, I don't know if you watch many creators, and this is an excuse of my actions, but I don't like watch all my friends' videos, unfortunately. I wish I could. And I'm looking at it now, and I'm so dumb for not seeing it. Like Artumbo repurposing videos. I do realize that the biggest offender, Clear Swarm Difficulty 5, Torturous Made Easy, was the, I believe that was the copy of ZMM's strategy. I can't believe I didn't see that, because I remember ZMM popped off of that and I was like, holy shit, how is he getting so many views? This is awesome. And that's when I think I talked to him before that, but that was around when we started being friends, and I was just like, damn, this guy's fucking popping off. And, I didn't see how Timbo was doing that.
Damn.
But,
yo,
what were your thoughts on all this? Because I only saw your stream, like,
Yeah. First of all, I'm gonna keep it like 100. I also don't really watch like other YouTube content creators in my own video, because I like absolutely no time, right? Because either you're making videos,
yeah,
or like, or for me, I'm either corporate videos or streaming, so I have absolutely like no time. So at most, I'll watch like the first like 10-20 seconds or something, like Mr. Global Certified's video. I try to watch like 10-20 seconds. Yeah, but generally speaking, I don't really go ahead and watch all those. So I think you're fine. Like you didn't really catch Artumbo, or you didn't really catch anything. It's completely fine. The whole situation, I'm not gonna lie, I feel that for the whole Guoba certified segment, it was a little bit ZMM getting quite emotional talking about it because of the Artamo thing. I think it's kind of like misdirected anger because like he can't just take it all out on Tombo, and then you kind of just went in there and like rubbed salt on his wounds, and then like, it stinged him. So he's trying to direct his anger. But honestly, in like objectively speaking, like the entire situation, I don't think that single comment on like a freaking Discord server with 8 ayaya emotes, I don't think that warrants like a whole ass segment in this video. I feel that you just happen to say the like what you said, right? You said the wrong things at the wrong time. So I think that's just my opinion on this. Yeah.
Yeah, like I have that a lot in the comments, like people saying overreaction, like it was just a comment. But at the same time, like I did like with Gacha Smack, like I should just not say it, even like, or say it like in private Gacha, private to Zeta, and private to Nagfrog. The problem is I don't know when to shut my mouth. So instead of like, I didn't know about that 4 month like stuff he's been holding on to. But
yep.
Even if I didn't, like I shouldn't have made that comment. The whole problem I have is I just yap on Discord. So it's like even if it was between Artumba and ZMM, me causing that, and especially since, yeah, like we've seen like Artumba is my friend, we've collabed in the past, so it looks really bad from my side. And it is bad from my side, I'm not saying it's not, but even if some people may say it's an overreaction, I still understand, because if I saw ZMM like in, I don't know, Kaching Main saying to like my friend Edison, like, oh, did Goba just copy your sheets for a video? Like, I would be pissed. I don't know if I'd make a video on it, but I understand that he did, and like, I don't think. Like, I like, even if you interpret it as overreaction, I don't think it's an overreaction that much. On my side, like, on our term, like, the amount of, like, 4 months is a long time to be holding on to that stuff. So,
absolutely.
And he even said he was still, like, 50-50 on it. So the fact that he even went through with it is pretty good on his side, because he was still, like, scared about doing it, because you're still, like, you're calling out other people. Even though I called him out through that message, even though Artumba was taking his content, he was still not making a video for so long. So it was just like a boiling point, and like my message was like the catalyst for it. So it makes sense that he makes a video now on it. Yeah, it's just understandable. But yeah, that's my reaction to the overreact. Like that's my response to the overreaction stuff. It's like, it could be interpreted as an overreaction, but if you put yourself in ZMM's shoes, it definitely, like, I would feel hella upset as well.
Yeah, definitely. I just feel that it was an overreaction by comparing what his reaction towards Artumba was compared to yours.
Right.
Like, yeah, like, if this was, like, a standalone comment, I think he's being pissed, but, like, because Artumba was, like, he stole like 200,000 overviews. So he should be like super fucking pissed about that. So I guess he just kind of need to let this off somewhere. Like he held it on for so long and he finally went through. And then, yeah, you just happened to be there and then shit just happened. Yeah.
Yeah, it's rough because although I am a cunt sometimes to people, like, I mean, I make fun of you.
That's such a British thing to say. I'm such a cunt.
It's such a British thing to say.
Oh, like, my God.
I make fun of you to your face. Like, absolutely. We banter. But it's like, because we're friends, but I didn't know ZMM enough to be able to do that.
Yeah, for sure.
And
for sure.
I just need to realize that, you know, I can't just, like, being rude isn't a personality. Like, I don't know what to say. It's like, I just feel like I should have been a way better friend to him, because you know our server with the
labs. Yep.
Our group of buddies, and we didn't really get to like incorporate him that much.
Yeah. It is
so
what
I
it's been, yeah.
I feel Do like, you like contact him?
Yeah, I tried to, but he hasn't responded yet, I think. Wait, let me see.
Yeah, nothing for
yeah,
me.
Yeah, he hasn't responded yet. Yeah, he hasn't responded. But yo, I feel that I think like a good ass resolution, if it will ever happen, is if like the three of y'all can get into like a call or something and then just talk it out. Whether you want to make it into a video, that's like up to y'all, but I think that would be a pretty good resolution. Yeah, 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 yeah. Between the three of you guys. And then Tecton has more things to react to, but yeah.
Oh, God, that, yeah.
Because like in the grand scheme of YouTube drama, the most important point of your YouTube drama is what happens afterwards. Like, what's the resolution? So I think if you guys manage to like come back and just get a good resolution together, it should blow off like quite okayly in a few months' time. Or a few weeks even, yeah.
Yeah, the only problem I have from this is the way I'm lumped in, like I'm like a collaborator to this, like I'm secretly, you know, funding Artumba's payroll or something. Like, I love Artumba. Like, I am, like, when I saw the video, I was like shocked at the stuff said on him. But it's like, we work together for a couple vids, sometimes we message each other, but not even that frequently. Like, sometimes we make like public jokes about being like super besties, but I don't have that many close friends, and it's not like that close either. And it's like, because he made those videos and I didn't see it, did any of his other friends see it? It's just because of the fact that I policed his content that now I look bad for not policing his, which I understand, but I'm also not checking every single video of his. The only reason I commented on ZMM's is because I saw his and Knack Frog's. So it was just like really bad timing to see that. If I saw maybe Artumba's and ZMM's at the same time, maybe I would have said the same thing. But I don't know. I just hate the lumping in part. But, you know, I mean, I'm not going to play victim. Like, it's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
If I get hate for it, like, it's the result of drama, I guess. But I just hope that part can go away. Like, I don't think I'm remaking his videos. I even didn't want to do Golden Gears, and I haven't done a video because his video was so good on it, and other videos were so good on it. Like, I was even thinking, and now this sounds dumb, I was even thinking of doing like a post recommending Knack Frog, ZMM, Sweet Elite, and yours for the Raw May. And I think there was another one. There was another really good strat.
Yeah.
I was thinking of doing that instead of video, because lots of people ask me for Golden Gears. They're like, Gobo, I can't watch these other creators. Make me a Golden Gears video. And it's like, no. I'd love to, but I don't have time. And it's like, have you not seen, like, this video has like 200k views. Like, Pokey's video shows how you do 2 Raw May. Like, what could I do? And yeah. So I mean, it's just really bad timing.
It's all good, man. Yeah, it's all good. But so are you gonna, because you mentioned your post, you're gonna make like a follow-up, right? So you're gonna be actually making a video about this.
Do you think I should do a video? Because the problem with Smack was I didn't apologize instantly, and I made it worse in Discord. I am not shit talking to anyone. I completely understand. I'm not accusing him of drama baiting or farming clout like I did with Gatchasmag. I'm not like I'm not making fun of him. I'm instantly apologizing because I do instantly realize the mistake I made, and I realize like I don't know. This just spoke to me more because ZMM like was a friend. Gatchasmag I didn't know, and I should have apologized instantly to Gatchasmag, but I didn't. But here I see. It's better to own up instantly, and instead of letting it like fester and let it make worse. So I don't know if I'll make a video. It's like, I don't know.
Okay, I feel like if you are gonna make a video, like make it where like the three of y'all actually has already came to a resolution. Yeah. So there's no more rooms for doubts. Like yeah. Just like make the only video you need, and then you'll just solve everything. Yeah.
I hope ZMM talks to me, because although my comment was completely out of place, I agree. Like, I still find that, like his beef was with Artumba, and although like to him, of course, I understand I look horrible. I still feel like I don't know, we could still be cool. Maybe he doesn't want to talk to Artumba, but I hope he at least wants to talk to me eventually about this all. But I hope also that he eventually wants to talk to Artumba, because I know Artumba is very chill, ZMM's very chill. This, like, from all three of us, this is like a sudden a difference. Like, ZMM is super chill whenever I see him. Like, even he was upset for 4 months, and instead of like being a cunt to me on the StarDB comment I made, he was just chill. He was like, yep, I credit people. He didn't roast me or be like, oh, why are you saying that and not saying about Artumba or some shit? And he, in the video, he showed himself like typing at Goba certified about Artumba, and he didn't even post it. I found that funny.
Yeah, it was.
He didn't even post it because he's just chill like that. Like, but yeah, so I hope we can talk. But if he doesn't, it would suck, but like, I understand.
Maybe not so soon. Maybe give it a few days. Yeah. I feel like he would.
It's 4 months to instantly start talking again.
Yeah, I think just give it some time. I mean, both you and Artumba has already apologized on the community post, right? So I feel that he just needs some time to cool off. And then eventually, when he's okay to open up, then the trouble can get into a call and we'll come to like a pretty nice resolution. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
I hope he's okay again. I saw someone already made a sticker of my holy back reading. Jesus.
It's gonna be a meme. It's gonna be a meme for sure.
Yeah, holy the back problem reading.
Absolutely.
Yeah, the one problem I have is the joke part. I think maybe I emphasize too much on that. But like, the problem I have with calling something a joke is then people start accusing you of calling everything else a joke. But the only part that was a joke was the holy back reading. Like, I mean, this is a common Goba sentence, holy plus a word.
Right.
That's the problem I have with it. It's that part was a joke. It shouldn't have been a joke. It shouldn't have even been there. But the rest of my apology was still very sincere. I still absolutely mean it. I hope ZMM reads it. There was a lot. If he doesn't have time for it, cool, but I hope he reads it. I think I wrote like 4 times the amount Artumba wrote.
Yeah, which is,
still...
which is crazy. Because like Artumba is like the main guy, and then his sentence is like 2 paragraphs, and then you wrote like fucking like a 2,000 word essay. Holy shit.
Yeah, I tend to go on too much, I guess. But Artumba is probably collecting his thoughts, probably realizing. But I need to avoid shitty jokes. That's one thing. Because
I think shitty jokes are fine. It's just that wrong place at the wrong time, I guess.
It was just the context. Yeah, it's the wrong place. I should have realized that. Like reading back, I'm like, oh, for fuck. Goba, what are you doing, bruv? I said holy back reading, and then the reply to his like comment, like he said his initial remembrance track or he used more time than a toilet, none of the bigger creators credited him, and all I said was holy back reading, all right, instead of saying oh I understand, etc. Suck and talk to the DMs. That was like
Okay, but I mean, he didn't really say anything, but different people just ultimately have like different tolerance to these kind of things. So I guess like he's really like not happy about it, and then like that holy back reading really just like, oh my god, fuck yourself, go about. Yeah.
It's completely my bad for doing that. I got some clown reacts on the message. So at least if people go back, they realize I was a clown there.
It's all good, man.
Are you making a video on it though?
All this is going to YouTube, by the way. All these are going to YouTube, so if you want to say hi to YouTube before we wrap it up.
Hi YouTube. Cool. That was my hi YouTube.
Okay.
That was a pretty shit hi YouTube.
Yeah, it's alright though. It's alright, yeah. I don't think it's super, super bad because like both parties really apologize. Just need to give it some time. Things should be good. Things should be good.
Yeah. I just hope ZMM contacts me when he's ready. Maybe he'll see this. Maybe he'll watch this or like Tech Turn or Gachasmack if he makes video. I contacted Gachasmack because I was like
100% them again video, but yeah.
Yeah. Because I posted on ZMM's post my like initial apology and it got deleted. So I was just saying that hopefully that gets showed. Because I did want to initially, I don't know what I'm saying anymore, but maybe one of his mods deleted or something, but my comment got deleted and I just hope that he's not like still mad and he like properly reads my apology.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe through this video he will, or this stream.
You know what's funny? Like, your current reaction is like, all these, it's, okay, this is just my opinion. I really feel it's not that bad for you. Like, it's just a distasteful joke that is said at the wrong time. I really don't think it does any harm, but I feel that it's a lot more serious for Artumbo if there isn't a proper resolution, because plagiarizing is a pretty serious thing, especially if you're like a content creator. So for his sake, I hope that a resolution can be kind of resolved between the three of y'all. Yeah, but I really think that you're fine. I really think that you're fine. Yeah.
Yeah, like I know that my actions still suck, but I do see that I feel like ZMM can come to a conclusion easier than he can with Artumbo. But I'm not gonna defend Artumbo. It's not gonna be like a 2v1 or something.
Yeah,
like,
just let them sort it out, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. I'm gonna like they can deal with their thing. Maybe I can deal with the fact that I didn't see Artumbo when I should have. Maybe I can deal with that. But yeah, the ZMM I hope I could just resolve my unnecessary comments with him and get back to content creating.
Yeah.
It's
good. I'll look forward to the Poke Goba day soon.
Yeah, when was that again?
I think 1 or 2 weeks before 2.0. Actually 1 week before 2.0. Yeah. Around there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks for the call, man. Hope you have a great day or night. Yeah.
You too. If you want to see my yapping apology, I mean, it's probably shit. I'm trash apologies, I think.
Sure.
But it is in the community post as well.
Oh, you posted a video already?
I posted on ZMM's video before I made the community post because I want to instantly address to him and then I made the community post.
Wait, so there's a video about it? Like, you made a video about it?
Oh, I didn't make a video. I made an apology on his video, and then I posted that in my community post.
Okay. Yeah, it's all good. Yeah.
But it is another fucking essay, so if you don't want to read that, I understand.
I'll take a crack at it. Yeah. But you take it easy, man. Yeah.
Yeah, see ya.
See ya. Well, chat, before we wrap up today's video, I'm not gonna read all that, right? Before we wrap up this YouTube video, I feel that the current situation of the entire Artumbo, Goba, ZMM drama, I think Goba is chill. It's like if you want to compare the crimes of Artumbo and Goba, Goba probably just yapped a little bit too much, while Artumbo should have just like punched someone in the face, right? So I think Goba is fine. Probably like he's really made like a 20,000 word essay. Like there's nothing more he could have said. He made one distasteful joke in one sentence and then he compensated it with like such a long essay. I really don't think there's much to be done. It's fine. But for Artumbo, I'm not even gonna lie. It doesn't look good. Cause at this point it's kind of like in the court of public opinions. Yes, he made the community post, right? He's already apologized, he's owned up to the mistake, but the thing is, the video is still there. It's still his third most watched video of all time. I don't know if there's ever going to be a resolution. I don't know if his reputation going forward is even going to still be there, because plagiarism is not a joke, guys. It is a very, very serious thing, especially if you're a content creator. Not even just for Honkai Story, but for like any sort of things you make, right? So I really, 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 really hope that I think Guoba is fine, but I hope that between Z, MM, and Artumbo, they can kind of just like get together and have a resolution, because if that doesn't happen, then it's going to be quite rough, right? So, yeah, that's the end for today's content. If you guys want to engage in any further discussions, head on over to Discord GG at Pokies Village, where we're a very active community talking about Hong Kong Saga on a daily basis. If you guys want to check out my stream, like right now with my Twitch chat over here, that's going to be at twitch.tv/MrPoky. I stream quite often nowadays. Schedule will be uploaded on Discord, and that's all I have for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.
I genuinely cannot believe this shit. I genuinely cannot believe this shit, guys. Did I say how I genuinely cannot believe this shit? I genuinely cannot believe this shit, guys.